The last time the trucks raced was in Las Vegas 3 weeks ago, but that day's moments set the scene for the championship chase.
Southampton Musgrave.
Musgrave is slowing. Musgrave is slowing in turns 3 and 4.
Looks like the right front tire's flat. The valence looks very, very low on the right side.
Which one is it, Ted? Right front.
Can you believe this? Just a few laps from back-to-back Vegas victory. The one will not win today.
I don't think he's going to give you a break.
White flag, baby. One more. Come on. One more.
David Starr has come so close, but he has never won his 66th career start. Bliss has less than a mile to catch him.
You're
and Starr
awesome,
will
you're
win
awesome.
At Las Vegas.
Way down,
Some people thought it was a big gamble this year when Wayne and Connie Spears picked a brand new driver named David Starr. They put him here in the 75 truck, and that gamble paid off in Las Vegas. In his 66th start, David Starr became a winner from the pole out there. And David, I have to imagine now your life's changed now that you've won in the truck series.
It really has. Hey, it's just an honor to be part of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series and to win our first race there in Las Vegas. It's just unbelievable. And we got a good shot at the race today, and hopefully we can pull the 75 Spears Chevrolet in a victory lane.
And, folks, they are definitely not out of the championship chase, even though they're 169 out with three races to go. Anything is possible. Now, the other guy you want to keep your mind on is the point leader. Mike Bliss starts fourth today. And in 10 of the last 11 races, he's had a top 10 finish. He won the very first race here at Fontana back in 1997 from the pole, and he's led the most laps here with 115 up front. If Bliss finishes fifth or better in the final three races, he clinches his first ever championship. Now, back in the field just a little bit is a guy who knows that he's the underdog. Rick Crawford has been 117 races since he went to Victory Lane at Homestead in 1998. He's had some bad luck here at California, but it turned around a year ago whenever he led 24 laps and finished second. These guys know they've got a shot at a championship, only 85 points out. But Crawford knows he's got to stay with Bliss in his sights if he wants to win it. Now, one other guy we've got to count in this championship chase is the number one. The number one truck was number one 1 year ago right here at California. And he has been the dominant truck so far in race trim here this weekend. Now, Ted Musgrave qualified 11th. Can he win from back there? Sure, he won from 12th a year ago. But today, he's got to go to the tail of the field because they changed an engine in this Mopar Dodge. Can he keep into this championship chase? Well, there are four drivers now that want to make a run at a three-race chase. Chance at a championship.
The last three races are going to be action filled.
We just got to keep pressing on what we're doing and hope for the best and bring the best each race.
We've won five races now. We want to win six or seven or eight more.
For me, I've got to throw caution to win and try everything I can possibly do to get every point that possible I can to catch up.
Hey, the Spears Motorsports team has a lot of momentum behind it.
We feel like we can beat anybody.
Winning the Craftsman Truck Series Championship would be the ultimate goal. And I have thought about it, but then right again, I roll over and count sheep.
We're not going to give up. We're fighting hard.
It would be a dream come true to win the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series Championship 2002.
We're going to try everything possible, take as many chances as we can.
ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports, is at California Speedway in Fontana for the American Racing Wheels 200, the 20th of 22 races this year in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Although several have a mathematical chance of winning the championship, it's basically down to four. Just 169 points separate Mike Bliss from David Starr, while Mike has only an 85-point advantage on second place, Rick Crawford. Hi, everyone. I'm Bob Jenkins, substituting for Jerry Punch, who's on another assignment along with Phil Parsons. We've talked about this tremendous championship battle going on. Now let's talk about today's race specifically. Some of the noise has been made this weekend by the three-truck Bobby Hamilton effort.
Bob, Ryan Hemphill, impressive 20-year-old rookie, had a great weekend going with a number four truck. Had an accident with 5 minutes to go in happy hour, considerable damage to the truck. Actually took him to the hospital. He's going to be okay, but he's going to have to sit out this race. Rick Bogart will start the race in his place at the back of the pack. Next, the eight truck of Bill Lester. Impressive, continues to impress. Career best third qualifying effort, tied that today for the third time this year. He's had a good happy hour, looking for that first top 10 finish, and today could be the day. And last but certainly not least, Robert Preston, the 18 truck. almost identical setup to what he had at Michigan with this same truck to win the race there. Danny Rollins, crew chief, said this is as close as we can get to Michigan. We think we got a shot at him. I look for him to stay up front.
Well, about the only difference between this track and Michigan, Michigan is banked at 18 degrees, and here in California, the banking is 14 degrees. The lineup and the start in a moment. ESPN Speed World coverage of the American Racing Wheels 200 is being brought to you by Coca-Cola and by Viagra. Ask your doctor if Viagra is right for you. Well, the field is on the backstretch and will be getting the green flag in about a lap and a half from right now. It's a two-mile track here at California Speedway near Fontana. Here is the starting lineup. David Starr in the Spears Manufacturing Chevrolet has his second consecutive pole alongside Coy Gibbs in the MBNA Chevrolet. That's his best qualifying effort ever here in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series.
Row 2, Bill Lester gunning for that first top 10 in the Dodge Motorsports Dodge. On the outside, Mike Bliss, our point leader with 5 wins already this year in the IWX Chevy.
In row number 3, Robert Presley, his first truck race here in California in the Dickey Square D Dodge. And Rick Bogart, who will be substituting for Ryan Hemphill, who was injured in a crash during happy hour yesterday, but will be okay.
Starting 7th, Travis Quaffle, our Memphis winner, has top 5 finishes in his last 3 races in the Cat Rental Store Chevy. And on the outside, Jason Leffler with 5 runner-up finishes, looking for that first win in the Team ASE Dodge.
Back in row number 5, the inside is occupied by the Napa Auto Parts Dodge, driven by Brendan Gaughan, number 62, his 3rd consecutive top 10 start. And then Rick Crawford, 2nd in points in the 14 Circle Bar Motel in RB Park Ford. However, it's his worst start since Loudon earlier this year.
Take a look at the next 15 starters. Here, look at in a 12th position, Andy Houston, 2-time pole winner here, runner-up in this race in year 2000. Terry Cook starts 13th, 4-time winner this year in the Power Stroke Ford. John Wood coming off his career best 3rd in this race last year in the Navy Ford in 15th. 17th, Matt Crafton, top 10s in the last 2 races here in the Menard Chevy.
And through the rest of the starting field, Stan Boyd starts back in 26th position. Brian Rose was the final driver to get in on speed. And the last 4 starters, Wayne Edwards, Phil Bonifield, Randy McDonald, and David Hall, are provisional starters. 36 ready to go here, and we have 5 onboard cameras that will complement our race coverage today.
Hi, I'm Ted Musgrave, driver of the number 1 Mopar Dodge. Why don't you come ride along with me? My other passenger got sick and failed out.
Hey, this is Brendan Gaughan. You're riding along with me in the number 62 Napa Auto Parts Orleans Hotel Casino Dodge Ram pickup. Step into my office.
Hi, this is Bill Lester, driver of the number 8 Bobby Hamilton Racing Dodge Motorsports Ram. Come on and roll with me, because we're going to go straight to the front. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Hi, my name's David Starr, driver number 75 Spears Motorsports Chevrolet. Jump in, buckle up, we're headed to the front.
And on board with Stars, we look back on the rest of the field. As we indicated, the corners are banked here at 14 degrees, and the pit window fill is 40 to 45 laps. So normally that's going to mean a 2-stop race, but will there be some that try just 1 stop?
Well, we definitely have one guy, Coy Gibbs, that has proven that he can go a long way on fuel. He went 110 miles at Michigan, so he may be the only guy here that can make it on 1 stop. If we don't have cautions to let people pin under caution.
And California is the place where we had the fastest race in Craftsman Truck Series history in 2000. And the green flag is out and we are underway. It's kind of hazy here in Southern California, but otherwise a beautiful day. The sun is out, no chance of rain. And here we go for 100 laps of racing on this 2-mile track. And David Starr has grabbed the lead already. Coy Gibbs right in behind him as they head for the backstretch on lap 1.
Side-by-side racing back and forth. Bill Lester on the inside of the left. Look at Rick Crawford making it pretty wide already. Coy Gibbs looking to the inside.
Crawford to the 14 truck, goes to the inside, tries to make up some position from his 10th starting spot. Meanwhile, Starr has about a three-car length advantage as he brings them around to complete lap number one. And beside him, or behind him, I should say, a side-by-side battle for a second. Gibbs will be second as they cross the line. Bliss is third, and Crawford has moved up to fourth already.
Another three-wide battle. Robert Preston, the inside, was able to take over that looks like the sixth position in the 18 truck. There's Brendan Gaughan, the blue truck in the center of the screen, number 62. There's Bill Lester and Travis Quaffle, the 60 truck.
Down the backstretch once again as Gibbs is positioned to the inside of the track now. Heading down for turn number three. Starr continues to hang on to the advantage here. Qualifying speed almost 176 miles an hour by David Starr.
You got David Starr up front, you got Mike Bliss in second, and Rick Crawford in third. There's three of our top four in points right there. David Starr knows he's got to lead this race. He's got to lead the most laps if he can. He needs those five extra points. Rick Crawford's thinking the same thing. He just passed Mike Bliss. He needs to get up there and lead this race.
Great side-by-side racing behind Starr. We're on board with Brendan Gaughan, who is shown back in seventh spot. He goes to the inside of Lester, and the 16 truck is going backwards, it looked like.
Big wiggle in the center of the corner. He got a little bit loose through the center. Most of the Chevrolets were complaining about being a little bit loose. That killed his momentum. That's why these guys are going by him.
Ray, what's going on?
Well, Bob, I think this happens each and every week. We see Mike Bliss not get a real good start. Part of that is the way they gear this truck. They want it to be good on a long run, and also they got to wait for the air pressures to come up. We see it week in, week out. Bliss usually loses 8 or 9 spots at the beginning of the race.
Well, not now. Mike begins to come back just a little bit. He was racing beside Bill Lester for a while. He's passed him and moved up to the seventh position. Here's what happened out in turn two.
See the two truck drive right up behind him. He got a little bit loose there. You see, he got a little bit loose, wiggled, and had to chase the truck up the hill. That allowed these guys to get by, killed his momentum. It took him another half a lap to get his momentum back. Now he's back in line. He's going to be okay.
Both Gaughan and Loeffler was able to get around, and as I said, he raced with Lester for a while, but now Mike is back on track, it would appear, as he tries to move up through the field once again.
That's Brendan Gaughan right there. He's right behind Brendan Gaughan. He's going to maybe take a look on the inside here.
Brendan is running in fifth position. Bliss is in sixth. And as they come down to complete another lap, it looks like Bliss has got a good run going to the top side of the racetrack with a little bit of help from Quaffle, and takes another spot.
Had some great momentum, as you mentioned, had a lot of help from Travis Quaffle. This is a big drafting track here. It's 2 miles. These trucks are not very aerodynamic. They punch a giant hole in the air. That's why these trucks draft so well.
Always a good NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series event on a super speedway like this. A couple of years ago, well, all the races they've run on super speedways, I'm thinking of one at Daytona that they ran a couple of years ago. That was probably the best race I have ever seen in my life, simply because they were able to stay together, draft a lot, and just swap the lead back and forth.
We had a race here about there's Ted Musgrave. He started about 31st, 32nd. He's already up to the 14th position, Bob, in what, 5 laps?
Ted Musgrave, Steve Portnoy, Dennis Setzer, Jerry Hill, Matt Crafton, and of course, the Ryan Hemphill truck. They all started at the back of the field for one reason or another, mostly because of engine changes, but of course a driver change in the instance of Ryan Hemphill. That's the number 20 truck of Coy Gibbs that is being challenged on the racetrack.
Jason Loeffler had a good run going on the outside. Jason really has run on the outside more than anybody here. He even qualified on the outside. He was the fastest truck, or one of the fastest trucks in practice. He really ran a wide line qualified. Did not qualify as well as he usually does, but he's already up to the third position.
David Starr continues to lead by about a half second over Rick Crawford. Loeffler is third, followed by the number 20 truck of Coy Gibbs. Back in a moment. Here on ESPN involving the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. The leader to your left is David Starr. A great battle for second position here. Rick Crawford is at the bottom of the racetrack and trying to get around. Up on the top side is Jason Loeffler, but he's going to have to get out of the gas and fall in behind Crawford as they come down to complete another lap. This will be the completion of lap number 8.
Jason's got a great line going up high here. He really gained on Rick. Let's see what he can do this time. Look at me. Drives to the top of the racetrack. Look at through the center of the corner. Look how fast with the momentum he keeps through the center of the corner. Look, he's almost going to clear Rick getting off turn two, but Rick's able to fight back on the inside.
Now they continue to run side by side down the back stretch. Great onboard shots here from Loeffler looking over two, Rick Crawford in the battle for second position, and Rick is once again going to be able to stave off the challenge for the moment. I'm impressed with the early performance here by Rick Crawford, who didn't have a particularly good qualifying performance, qualifying back in 10th position. Boy, the drop of the green flag, he set sail for the front and is within one position of being there.
Rick can hold his own on the inside of the racetrack through three and four, but Jason is so good through the center and one and two here. See what he can do this time. This side-by-side battle is allowing Coy Gibson, the 20 truck, and Robert Preslin, the 18 truck, to catch them, but Jason can't quite clear Rick coming off turn number two.
Crawford, one of only three drivers in the field to start all six Truck Series races previous here at California Speedway, and the other two, Terry Cook and Lance Norrie.
We had a race here back in 97 or 98. We were here with the Busch cars. We had a Busch truck weekend.
Mm-hmm.
This truck race was one of the best races that I had ever seen on anything other than the Daytona Talladega type racetrack in my life, and I've seen a lot of races.
Well, as you indicate, these trucks are so big they can punch a big hole in the air, and that just creates a tremendous opportunity to get behind somebody and draft. And we got about a five truck draft going on right here with two, three, four, five, and six. Star with about a 0.6 of a second lead on second place, Jason Leffler. There's look at Coy Gibbs, who started fourth and currently started second, but currently runs fourth position.
Remember, Bob, this is the guy that gets the best fuel mileage in this entire field. He's got a great truck. He can stay up front. He's going to be in touch with the leaders the whole race. If this thing goes green and he stretches his truck to 50 or 51 laps, he could win this race on fuel mileage, but you never know what can happen. Ray?
Well, Phil, I don't know if they're getting that good of mileage here this weekend. I talked to Curtis Markham, this spotter, and he said he'd be surprised if they can go 45 or 46 laps today. Now, some of that is based on practice, and it'll be different out here in race conditions. Yeah, they get the best mileage all the time, but remember, at Las Vegas, they weren't quite as good as they've been, and I think part of that is because the way Coy's been driving the truck and what they've done with the engine, but maybe not as good a mileage today as what they've been getting in the past.
Ray, I think Curtis might be whooping you, because one of the guys told me that they thought they could run at least 52, 53 laps. So you might have been, they might have been whooping you a little bit down there, Ray.
That won't be the first time that's happened, I'm sure. 12 laps completed. And once again, David Starr continues to hang on to the lead. Leffler running in second spot, and Rick Crawford is in third. And now Leffler has come right up onto the tailgate of that 75 truck.
Leffler's got a great truck right now. He was pretty good and happy. He was not quite as good as his teammate, Ted Musgrave. Everybody in the garage area said Ted Musgrave is the guy to beat. It didn't matter where he was starting, he's going to be the guy to beat. But we've got a side-by-side battle for the lead rider, Jason Leffler, making it work on the outside.
He drops in behind Starr at the moment, now takes the lead, and Jason Leffler becomes our second leader of the afternoon.
You see him running a little bit higher line than anybody else here, and he's really making it work for him.
The first time that Leffler has competed in a NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series event here at California. However, he has run in the Busch Series and in the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. Finished 18th back in 2001 and was 39th in a Busch Series start in 2000. But right now, Leffler has the lead.
This is the first race he's led since Richmond, which was several races ago. He led every race beginning of the year for the first 8 or 10 had led every race, but this was the first one he had led since Richmond, and he's not good battle for second. Rick Crawford pull up on the inside of David Starr.
Crawford to the inside and Starr to the outside. In the battle for second is Coy Gibbs and others look on behind him. They come off of corner number four. They're still wheel to wheel coming down here to the start finish line. Crawford goes almost inside that white line but continues to battle side by side. And look at Robert Presley making it a side by side battle with Coy Gibbs.
Got a great battle. Got six trucks battling for the second position right now. We talked about Robert Presley, how good this truck was at Michigan. He won the race going away, had a great truck. He was really good in happy hour. Again, Danny Rollins said, hey, I think we can do it again.
And they could very well. Presley in a very good run so far, Ray.
Yeah, he is, Bob, and this truck is called Angel, and it's their favorite there at Bobby Hamilton. It's the 12th time they've run this truck in 2002, and it also ran 12 races a year ago. Joe Ruttman won with it at Pikes Peak in 2001, but Angel is certainly their favorite, and they plan on using this truck the final three races as long as it doesn't get hurt.
And that truck has a little bit different look to it this week, doesn't it, Phil?
It sure does. They've got a great paint job, a nice-looking truck. You got the Dickey sponsorships, predominantly blue and red. In the past, it's been predominantly red with some blue, but a great looking truck right now and doing a great job with it.
Square D will continue to be on the hood of the truck for here and at Homestead. Our rather for Phoenix, and then Homestead just Dickies. Looking back on David Starr and Coy Gibbs.
I gotta mention Ted Musgrave started back 31st, 32nd, already in the top 10. 16 laps into this race.
Before qualifying yesterday afternoon, they found some water in the engine, and that necessitated an engine change. And the NASCAR rules state that if you do change an engine during a weekend, regardless of what the reason, you have to go to the back of the field for the start.
Tough break for him. I think that's why he didn't qualify as well as we would have, as we usually see Ted Musgrave qualify, because there really wasn't anything to gain. The only thing he gained by qualifying was how he picked his pit position. So he didn't want to go out there and just completely give up. So I think he was a little bit conservative, didn't qualify as well as he would have, but the truck is awesome.
That's Mike Bliss working the high side of the racetrack as he takes the sixth position. The lead continues to be held by Jason Leffler. Only two races to go. The Phoenix International Raceway will play host to the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series next week under the hot desert sun. They'll scorch the track for the 12th time in series history. The championship hunt rolls on as former Phoenix winner Mike Bliss eyes his first Truck Series title. You can catch the action live on ESPN2 Friday, November the 8th at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. We're at California Speedway in Fontana for the American Racing Wheels 200, and we have completed 18 of the 100 laps. Jason Leffler has now extended his lead to well over a second.
You know, we talked for a lot of this season is when with Jason Leffler going to win a race. He has 5 runner-up finishes. But we haven't talked about it much lately because we've been concentrating so much on the championship. But Jason Leffler may not be a threat to win this championship, but he's certainly a threat to win this race.
Bliss making his way back up through the field. We saw a shot of him just before we went to break. He's now moved up to fifth position and battling for that as we have a debris caution coming out on the racetrack for the very first time. There's debris in turn number one, and that will cause the race to go under caution for the first time on lap number 20.
Bob, we've completed 20 laps. That's almost halfway to a pit stop. I think all these guys are going to pit. Now, I'm not sure about Coy Gibbs,
yeah,
but I think the rest of these guys have no choice but to come in and get some fuel, and that will allow them to make the rest of this race on one more pit stop.
Good point. We'll see if that happens. There is Coy Gibbs. We'll see if he is among those who comes in for a pit stop. Well, Leffler had gotten the lead and began to drive away. However, all that lead now is extinguished as the caution comes out.
A big break for Ted Musgrave too. He had driven up into the ninth position, but he was about 8 or 9 seconds behind. This is going to allow him to close up with a good pit stop. He's going to be right there with him.
On board with Bill Lester here, who has dropped back to the 11th position as the pace truck is on the speedway. The pit speed, by the way, is 55 miles an hour, and it looks like several of the teams, as you speculated, Phil, are getting ready for a stop.
David Starr's Spears bunch getting ready on top of the wall, getting ready to service that truck.
By the way, you undoubtedly missed a very familiar voice on our NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series coverage. In addition to Jerry Punch, who was on another assignment, but Amy East is a bit under the weather, and Ray Dunlap is doing solo duty on pit road here this afternoon. Well, let's go down to Ray as we have Leffler, Crawford, and Bliss coming in.
Well, Leffler's truck's been snug off of two. They've talked about it being a little loose off four, so they weren't quite sure what to do. It will be a four-tire stop this time, and they're going to try to fix it with air pressure going up on the right front a little bit. Leffler will come in. He'll be right ahead of Crawford here. We'll keep our eye on that pit stop. These guys go to the right side. Everything looks pretty smooth for Matt Puscia and Jeremy West on the two truck. Crawford's going to go with four tires as well, and they'll also do a small wedge adjustment. Now, when we look at the 16, it's fuel only for Mike Bliss, and they were going to make a track bar adjustment on the 16, but they wanted track position. So Bliss will be the first truck out, and a really even pit stop for the 14 and the 2. The 2 will beat them off, and we had a very, very long pit stop for David Starr. Starr is going to lose seven or eight spots right now because they had a hang up on the left front wheel. A couple of lug nuts came loose. So Star, the big loser in this round of pit stops.
And you notice the 20 truck of Coy Gibbs did come in for a stop. We'll take a break and be back right back with more from California. Just about to go back to green here at California Speedway. Here's our Craftsman pit summary. Leffler from first to second, and the big gainer was Star lost from fourth to 11th, and Bliss gained with a gas-only stop. He is the current leader. Ray?
Well, Bob, let's find out from crew chief Dave Fuge Jr. What was your plan there? Fuel only? I know you got out front and got some bonus points. Was that the reason?
Well, really, we didn't know what everyone else was going to do, so we just decided to take fuel now and play for the end of the race. Tires were pretty good. They came in real well. We were fast there in the media part of the run there. So, yeah, we'll get five bonus points. That was a help, and we'll see what happens.
Hey, that's Dave Jr.
Green flag comes out. We are back to racing here at California Speedway. Now, up front, Bliss and the two truck of Leffler are side by side, and here comes Crawford to make it three wide.
That's the second time we've seen Rick Crawford make it three wide. He's going to be able to pass those guys, take the lead. Let's see if he can hold it and get around and get those 5 points.
Wow, another impressive start for Rick Crawford, who has taken the lead from Bliss, who kind of rolled the dice and decided to go only for gas only, getting him up front, but he's not going to lead at least this competitive lap as Crawford comes down and leads lap number 25.
I think Mike Bliss accomplished his objective. He led under caution flag. He led us to the restart.
Yep.
So he got his 5 points. Look at Ted Musgrave, the one truck. Everyone said in the garage, this is the fastest truck. We saw how fast Jason Leffler's teammate was. He just drove by him, and now he's driving by Coy Gibbs.
Boy, leaving Coy Gibbs down the backstretch. Now Gibbs fighting back a little bit on the outside, but this is the battle for third position. Musgrave to the inside, Coy Gibbs to the outside, and Musgrave is going to take the spot as we're watching from Jason Leffler's perspective, and he's got his hands full with Robert Presley.
Robert Presley on the inside. We saw how dominant Ted Musgrave was through the center of the corner right there. I tell you, his truck is really, really set up well. We heard him talking. They opened the show. He's going to have to take some chances. He's got to do everything he can do. Well, right now, he's getting ready to take the lead from Rick Crawford.
Yeah, that was a very interesting comment that Musgrave made. He basically is saying, I've got to drive as aggressively and as fast as I possibly can in these last three races if I'm going to win the title. And he's doing just that.
Here he is right now running second, racing the 14 truck of Rick Crawford to lead, driving right by on the outside. He has now overcome the fact that he had to start at the back. We're 25 laps into this race, and he's back in the lead. Look at Robert Presley going for second, three wide on the inside.
Ted Musgrave will lead this lap, and he has led more laps this year than any other driver in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. And now the battle is for second position.
We saw Mike Bliss early in the race have a little bit of trouble at the start. Ray documented the fact that Mike was always a little bit off on the restarts and the starts of the race, but I thought maybe with the fact that he had the same tires with his air pressures already built up, that may be better for him on the restart, but he's still been passed by a couple trucks on this restart.
On board with Brendan Gaughan here. And the battle for third position now. That is Bliss that has third. Leffler right behind him. There's Gibbs in the 20 truck and the 14 of Rick Crawford.
We saw Rick Crawford, the 14 truck, leading just a minute ago, and now he's all the way back to the sixth position.
Musgrave begins to stretch out the advantage just a little bit here as he sees side-by-side racing in his rearview mirror, and Bliss with that much higher line through the corners than anyone else. And now we've got four trucks battling for position side-by-side.
I don't think Mike Bliss wants to be in this position right now. He's got that championship on his mind a little bit, and he doesn't want to have three trucks on the inside of him. David, so you heard him pedal a little bit off the corner. He probably lost the front a little bit, had to keep the front end down, had to pedal the throttle. Look at Dennis Setzer going with a 46 truck on the inside to make it three wide.
He gets way down on the apron to get to the inside of the 75 truck of Star.
What a race here. Look at, they're running three or four different lanes through the corners.
Nice wide racetrack, and we have that. You got multiple lanes, and you got great racing. That's Setzer.
and look how close they are.
Great to see that new sponsor Makita on this truck. He had it last race for the first time. Remember, he's another guy that went to the rear. That's why we didn't talk about him early in the show. He had to go to the back of the pack because they had to change engines.
And Makita Power Tools are headquartered in nearby La Mirada, California, so a lot of people here rooting for Dennis Setzer, and he's made a nice move toward the front in the first 29 laps of this race.
Dennis finished fourth in this race last year, so he's no stranger to running well at California Speedway.
This is his fifth truck race here at California Speedway. You're right, his best finish was fourth last year. And we see Terry Cook now, and Setzer running side by side.
There's Bill Lester, the A truck, right behind that battle.
And look at Brendan Gaughan here on the inside of the track. He's going by several.
Like he was shot out of a cannon, looked like. I don't know if those guys got together coming off turn two and slowed him down, but Brendan looked like he had 100 more horsepower than they did coming off that corner.
And he has moved up to third spot.
This is a brand new truck. They had this truck at Las Vegas. It was really, really good, and he had a little bit of a problem in happy hour, and they banged it up a little bit, had to get the backup out. So this is truck number eight of the first race for this truck.
We saw him, as you said, looking like he had 100 more horsepower when he got down to the inside. But then when he got alongside some trucks, the momentum kind of stopped. Is that all related to aerodynamics?
Well, I think it has a lot to do. It looked like in that corner, Mike Bliss may have had the same thing happen to happen the lap before. He got up wide, looked like he lost the front end. He slowed everyone down behind him, and I think that's why Brendan was able to get such a run off turn number two. You hear David Starr, you hear him kind of pedal and throttle there. These guys are really fighting tight through the center and off the corner. So he's got to try to ease off the throttle. Otherwise, you just lay on that right front tire and it scrubs off so much speed.
Starr running in ninth position, a little more than 4 seconds behind the leader of the race, Ted Musgrave. Robert Presley is that close to the leader, Ted Musgrave.
These are two guys beginning the season. They finished 1-2 in the first two races we had. Presley winning Daytona, Musgrave winning Darlington. We thought the whole year was going to be a Musgrave and a Presley show, but a bunch of these guys have stepped up to the plate. Ted Musgrave still in his championship hunt. Robert Presley's had a great year. He's won two races, but not in the championship hunt.
Presley currently seventh in the point standings coming into this event. Meanwhile, Ted Musgrave has two wins so far this year. But he has never won at the same track twice, and he is the defending champion of this event. So he's hoping he can get that change this afternoon.
I'm really impressed with Robert Presley, how he can hang in here with Ted Musgrave. Again, we said early in the race in the open of the show that Robert Presley had the same truck that he had at Michigan to win, but Ted Musgrave seemed to be so good in happy hour, but Robert Presley's hanging right with him.
And a quick update on the one truck from Ray.
Well, Bob, I told you that Robert Presley was going to take that same truck to the final three races. Ted Musgrave will not. He's driving chassis number 12 today. When we go to Phoenix, they'll take truck number 20. So these guys have prepared for a championship chase in a different way. They've got trucks ready all the way through the final three races, and Musgrave's truck looks awfully good today. I don't know, Phil, would you take this one or not?
If he can hang out and win this race like he's leading it right now, I'd be hard fought to get me not to take it. I'll tell you that.
Why change a winning combination? We'll be back with more with 67 laps to go. Countdown provides up-to-minute NFL news hosted by Stuart Scott with Tom Jackson, Ron Jaworski, Sterling Sharp, and Chris Mortensen. That's at 7:30 on ESPN, and then that'll take you right up to the big battle in Monday Night Football on ABC between the Dolphins and the Packers from Lambeau Field. That's at 9 o'clock Eastern Time. We're at California Speedway near Fontana and the American Racing Wheels 200. The race is currently being led by Ted Musgrave. We're on board with him right now, looking back on Robert Presley, who's running in the second position. Third would be Rick Crawford. Jason Leffler is fourth. And running in fifth position is the number 60 truck of Travis Quappel. With only three races remaining, we asked Ted Musgrave if he would change his driving style in a last-ditch effort to capture the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series Championship.
Well, if you go back and watch the Las Vegas race, I think that shows you what we're going to have to do. You know, the truck was not the fastest truck by no means, but we were going to win the race. And there's going to be some moves made. There's going to be things happening. definitely, I'm going to change my style a little bit. You're going to see so much aggressiveness that it doesn't matter. You know, like I said, we're going to try everything possible to take as many chances as we can.
And right now, Musgrave and Presley are involved in a great battle for the lead. Presley, I thought, was going to get him at the end of the backstretch, but on the top side, Musgrave maintains the momentum, but now Presley once again challenges.
Pulls ahead a little bit, probably looks like he's going to lead that lap. See if he can. Musgrave fights back on the outside. See, Presley can't quite drive in the corner as hard as he wants to with Musgrave on his outside, because if he slides up the racetrack, he slides into Musgrave. So he's got to kind of be a little bit careful getting down in the corner.
Presley did get credit for leading that lap, so five, make that six drivers have now led in the first 37 laps of this race. Starr has led the most, 12. Musgrave has led 11. Leckler, 9. Crawford, 2. Bliss, 2. And Presley, as we said, that last lap. But I don't think that Robert is going to lead this lap, because Musgrave has the lead back.
Probably early in the season, they wouldn't be that big a deal to Ted Musgrave. He may not fight Robert Presley, but he has to lead the most laps. That's the only way that he can win this championship, is to lead races, lead the most races, and try to win these races. So he does not want to give up that lead.
And now a third contender, as Rick Crawford has come up right behind the Robert Presley truck. Mike Bliss has 4 wins this year. Musgrave has 2 victories. And look at the average finish for Mike Bliss, who is, of course, the points leader and could very well walk off with his first NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series championship. And David Starr also has a great average finish in the year 2002.
Mike Bliss had a problem at Daytona. He blew an engine at Daytona. Since the Daytona race, our first race of the season, he has completed all but one lap the rest of the season. That is pretty incredible.
It sure is. And now Presley once again to the inside of Ted Musgrave in the battle for the lead down the backstretch. Presley to the inside and inches ahead just barely on Musgrave.
You know, we talk all year about aero push. A lot of the guys in the garage area, whoa, was that close getting by Ricky Sanders in the 19 truck. A lot of the guys said, we don't feel the aero push here in California like we do at some other places. And the fact that Robert Presley is able to drive up beside Ted Musgrave, I think that says to me that he's not having a problem with aero push.
Well, Presley had to get out of the throttle just a little bit, and now is about a truck length behind the leader Musgrave, although he's charging up again, Ray.
Well, great battle out there, Bob. Musgrave and Presley both pitted on lap 21. Musgrave made absolutely no changes, but Presley did make a wedge change because his truck was a little bit tight off. Well, guess what? That wedge change hasn't worked very well, because now he's loose in the center of 3 and 4. So that's why he's not be able to make a run on Musgrave down there in 3 or 4, because he's loose in the center.
That lap that Presley led, however, was the first time that he has led since Michigan, the race that he won in July. Here's Bliss on the top side with Cook in the battle for position. That's the battle for ninth spot. And the points as of now show Crawford within 54. So he has, at this moment, flipped a few points off of the advantage that Bliss has over him.
That's a big jump, a 31-point jump right there. I think if Rick Crawford could leave this racetrack gaining that many points on Mike Bliss, he would be tickled to death.
Down the back stretch, that is Setzer in the blue truck in the middle of the racetrack.
You know, all these guys are going to say, hey, we're here to win the race, Bob. We're not thinking about points, or it's in the back of our mind, or whatever. Still a good battle for the lead with Ted Musgrave and Robert Presley. But, you know, I think they've got to be thinking about these points. I don't think there's any way around it.
Well, especially people like, I think Bliss would have a different mindset than anybody else. He's the points leader. And if he can see an opportunity to finish well and not necessarily win the race, he's going to do it. But everybody else chasing him, especially somebody like Ted Musgrave, who's third in points, yeah, they have got to say, hey, we got to pull out all stops and do what we can.
They have to have less pressure on them, because they know exactly what they have to do. They have to go out and try to win the race.
Yep.
Where, as you mentioned, Mike Bliss can finish fifth the last three races.
Yep.
Another battle for the lead side by side. They're not going to get away from each other.
Yep. And Presley is going to lead this lap, it would appear. great side-by-side battle between Ted Musgrave on the top side and Robert Presley in the Dickies number 18 on the bottom side of the racetrack.
Robert just can't quite clear him through the center of the corner. You heard Ray mention that he's a little bit free through the center of the corner, a little bit loose, but he's getting through the center of the corner pretty well. If he could tighten that truck up a little bit in the center, he would really be awesome.
We're nearing the halfway point of this race. They're on lap number 44 at the moment. And now Crawford has a good run at the bottom of the racetrack.
He's no stranger to making it three wide.
And Crawford is going to pull alongside Musgrave here on the tri-oval portion of the racetrack.
Rick Crawford has to have the same mindset as Ted Musgrave. He's second points. He's got to get up here, lead this race. He needs to lead the most laps, and he needs to win this race and see how far back Mike Bliss finishes.
So the side-by-side battle for second is between the 14 of Crawford and Robert Presley. We'll be right back.
I'll tell you what, that Mopar Dodge gets no luck this year.
Here is Musgrave, the leader is spinning.
Musgrave said that he hit some oil, you guys, and it sent the truck spinning. They're afraid they've got some flat spots. They think they're going to bring him down and give him four fresh tires.
Unbelievable turn of events.
Tires had just totally gone away on Ted Musgrave's Dodge. The right side's right rear, he said he wasn't going to be able to hold on to it. Going to have a penalty on Musgrave.
That's going to cost him at least five positions in this race.
Something happened to Musgrave.
Musgrave is slowing. Musgrave is slowing in turns three and four. He is on the apron.
Right front tire down. Can you believe this? Just a few laps from back-to-back Vegas victory. Oh, man, the right front is gone. It's completely down. Luckily, it's down to the inner liner. The one will not win today.
Some of the troubles that Ted Musgrave has experienced during this NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, but right now here at California Speedway, he is leading the race by just about 0.2 seconds over Robert Presley, and Presley beginning to charge up once again. Musgrave was the fastest in happy hour at almost 173 miles an hour. He qualified 11th, but as we've documented, had to go to the rear of the field because he changed engine. Started 31st. Here he is leading, but look at the traffic behind him. Travis Quappel running third.
We haven't said a whole lot about Travis Quappel. Having a great run. Pat Reynolds stores Chevy. Mike Eddington and the guys doing a great job. Rick Wren, crew chief. They really need a sponsor. They're looking for a sponsor to continue this truck. And he's a consistent threat to win this race. Look at him on the inside there. Going to try to get by. He helped Robert Presley.
Yep.
Pushed him by Ted Musgrave to take the lead. That's the first time we've seen Presley able to clear Ted Musgrave. And I think it's because Travis Quappel pushed him by.
Yep. Quappel was unable to tag along and run into second position, but he did help Presley get the lead for the second time in the race. But look at Musgrave going to the top side of the racetrack again. There was a little bit of smoke from that truck.
Looked like might have been a bump down there. May have been a bump, and the fender may have rubbed the tire a little bit. But look at this great side-by-side action. Ted Musgrave made the move on the outside. Here's his teammate. We're looking at it. His onboard, Jason Loeffler, early leader, making his way back to the front right now, racing Travis Quappel for the third position.
Loeffler led 9 laps earlier, currently is in third. As ahead of him, we see Presley and Musgrave, who has taken the lead once again. I've been watching Jason Loeffler drive race cars and trucks for many years. Of course, he started in the USAC circles, but his hometown is Long Beach, California, not too far from here. And so he considers this racetrack, Fontana, which is about 40 miles from the Pacific Ocean inside Los Angeles, as his home racetrack.
He sure would like to get a win on his home racetrack, but right now he's got a couple Dodgers in front of him. Ted Musgrave in the 1 and Robert Presley in the 18, and Bob, they're side by side.
Imagine that. Side by side, just as close as they could possibly get. Now Musgrave with a half a car length advantage, and Loeffler looks like is going to go up top and follow Musgrave around. And so Presley will now drop into second position here as a slow truck is up ahead on the left, but
not so fast. How about look at Travis Quappel? We saw he got pushed by Travis Quappel again by Ted Musgrave.
Great four-truck battle for the lead here in California as we have completed 50 laps. The crossed flags are being shown to the drivers as they come down. 50 laps completed and 50 to go. We're looking over on Travis Quappel. So it is a great battle up front between Presley and Musgrave, and we'll be back in a moment. Well, you can catch up on all the news from the world of motorsports on RPM tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern on RPM2, your nightly source for motorsports news. For more, log on to ESPN.com. On board with Bill Lester here, he has slipped back to the 12th position now after having started up in third spot.
Bill's still doing a good job, really a threat to get that first top 10 finish. He really desperately wants to get a top 10 finish for this Bobby Hamilton team. And I think today, again, may be the day. He's got some great trucks in front of him. Every truck in front of him is a race winner or a potential race winner, so he's doing a super job.
Very likable guy who's actually from Northern California. His parents reside in Oakland, California. Last week, he took his Bobby Hamilton team to lunch, and they decided after lunch they didn't want to go back to work, so they all engaged a football game.
Yeah, Bill considers this his home racetrack, yep. So he desperately wants to do well. And his teammates not doing too bad either. One of his teammates for sure.
Yeah. Presley is the leader as they come down to complete lap number 53. Talk about the driver's points championship and the manufacturer's championship points. Well, that's a good battle too, as Chevy has 133 points. Dodge 120 and Ford 108, with most of the wins this year to the Chevy contingent.
I think the way they have it determined, if Chevy can finish anywhere besides third in the last three races compared to the other manufacturers, they will win this championship. So if they can, in other words, if a Dodge wins this race and they finish in front of a Ford, I think they may clinch at least a tie for this manufacturer's yep. championship. So that's pretty serious when you talk to the manufacturers about these manufacturer championships.
On board with Jason Leffler, the number two team won this race in 1997 with Mike Bliss driving. Right now, Jason Leffler is currently in third position, running seventh, and he looks to his right and he sees the 60 truck of Travis Quappel coming on.
Great run on the inside. That's the same truck Travis ran in Michigan. He finished third. He's had three top fives in his last three races. This truck always runs well. He's got two poles here with Andy Houston and two second place starts with Andy Houston and Travis Quappel.
And of course, Travis was the rookie of the year in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series last year. Ray?
Well, Bob, this track here at California and the track at Michigan always tend to get tighter as the race goes later. So Rick Wren, the crew chief on the 60, told me they made a last-minute adjustment right before they went to the tech line today to try to loosen this truck up just a tiny bit to try to make it better. Now, he just came on the radio, and he said, Travis, we can win this race. All you got to do is beat a Dodge. And another Dodge. And another Dodge. Now, speaking of another Dodge, there's a 62 right behind Travis Quappel, and that is Brendan Gaughan. Now, Gaughan's truck is a little bit tight through one and two, and he's really, really tight coming off of turn four. So they're going to try to make a track bar and an air pressure adjustment on our last pit stop here to try to get him a little bit better and see if he can be a contender.
And speaking of rookies of the year, as Quappel was last year, here's a guy who's really run away with the Rookie of the Year honors this year in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series.
Sure has won two races, both the races at Texas. Had some great other top fives. Here you see our rookie points right now. Again, a pretty insurmountable lead over Bill Lester right now, but Brendan Gaughan is a threat to win each and every week, and right now he's running up in the fifth position in top five.
Likes the Texas track. He won two races this year at Texas. We'll take another break and be back with more. It's Presley, Musgrave, Quappel, Leffler, and Gaughan. Well, the 2002 NHRA Power 8 drag racing season comes to an end this coming weekend. And the big title is for Funny Cars. Will it be John Force or his teammate Tony Pedregon, who he hired in 1996? It's going to be a battle to the end in that division. You can see the qualifying on ESPN2 Saturday at 10 Eastern, then Sunday, November 10th on ESPN. Final eliminations at 5 Eastern, continuing on ESPN2 at 7 Eastern. That is in nearby Pomona, California, which is just a few miles from here in Montana, at the Oval California Speedway. Well, there they are. The 18 of Robert Presley leads this race, but now Quappel has moved to second.
Yeah, we've completed 59 laps, working lap 60 right now.
Ted Musgrave's guys were telling me this morning that they're not sure that they were not getting very, very good fuel mileage. They're not sure they could run 40 laps, so we pitted on lap 21. So we're within a few laps, I think, of seeing some pit stops.
Yep. That will allow them to go the rest of the way. There's the 89 of Stan Boyd to the outside of those running up front. Boyd is not on the lead lap. He is being shown back in 20th position.
Dodge battling right there for the fourth position. Jason Leffert with the two Dodge. Brendan Gaughan, the 62.
And Rick Crawford has come onto pit road. Crawford among the first of those running up front to make a pit stop. He is pitted down toward pit out. Let's go to Ray.
Well, Bob, I told you everyone's talking about tight, tight, tight. So they said, let's loosen this truck up a little bit. We knew the pit window would be between lap 60 and lap 69. So we got variant strategy. Mike Bliss also preparing to come in here. Now, this is a four-tire stop for the 14 guys. Everything looked pretty routine. Cal Beaufrey and Bobby Showalter changing the tires, and they get it done routine. Fuel is in. That should be Crawford's last stop. I expect a 16 to come in one lap, and also we're hearing the 1 and the 2 are preparing to come to pit road.
So Crawford has the truck back on the racetrack, and here is Bliss, as Ray indicated, as he has his IWX Motor Freight Chevrolet coming down at 55 miles an hour, and he too is one of the pits down toward pit out. So it's a long, long haul down pit road at 55 miles an hour. But Ray, he's finally arriving in your area.
And Bob, it's going to take just a little bit longer for this pit stop because Dave Fuge Jr. on the rear tire is going to put a spring rubber in there. That usually takes another second or two, but they do it very quickly. Now they get the tire back on there, get ready to go. Right sides are done as the crew comes around. We see that Chris Showalter's on the front, Dave Jr. on the back, the Jackman and Steve Hill. These guys doing very routine so far. Slowed them down just a little bit on the rear. The fuel is in, and Bliss will head back to the racetrack. 23-7.
And meanwhile, Quabble wants the lead from Presley as they race side by side down the backstretch and into turn number 3. And Presley on the outside is able to hold off Quabble's challenge. Quabble has not led a lap so far, but maybe he'll be able to do it here. We'll watch him come down.
Side by side coming down. Looks like, see which way Ted Musgrave goes. Who's he going to push? Or is he going to go in the middle?
I don't know. I'm not sure who led that lap. It was close.
Musgrave, I tell you, he told us he was going to be aggressive, and he has been aggressive. He's not leading this race because he doesn't want to. If he could get by these guys, and he's fought tooth and nail to try to stay in front of Robert Presley and then beat Robert Presley, but right now he's got the 60 truck.
And Dennis Setzer is on pit road as he arrives for what should be his last pit stop. Crew goes to work on the right side of the truck.
That's one thing about a 200-mile race here. You're going to have to make two pit stops. That doesn't give you a whole lot of time to adjust these things. You know, in a 400 or 500-mile Winston Cup race, Bob, they can make adjustments throughout the whole day. You've got two shots at it, and you better get it right.
You don't have much opportunity to end now. Setzer completes his stop. Here comes both Musgrave and Leffler down pit road, right behind each other. Ray?
And Bob, as Ted comes down here, same thing as I told you about Crawford. They said, loosen it up, loosen it up. Steve Haraney and Kyle Petty are the tire changers there. The number one is here. Now, the two came through also. One tire gets away a little bit. That might slow him down a bit. Haraney gets his tire off on the left front here. Jack is up. This looks like a pretty good stop for Musgrave. Musgrave will do it. They have a bad problem on the two, though. They had a hang up on the left rear there for the number two truck. He's going to lose 2 or 3 seconds to Musgrave. They come down pit road together, but they leave with about a 4-second differential.
Terry Cook also on pit road, and now Presley has entered pit road. Robert Presley relinquishes the lead as he comes down for his stop. And Ray Presley is having a stop.
And I told you earlier that Presley was loose in the center, so they're going to make a wedge adjustment there on the number 18. One round down on the right side. Crew chief goes over there. The crew chief is a tire changer. That's Danny Rollins. And these guys seem like they've got a pretty routine stop going here. Left rear tire takes just a second to get off. We'll have to take a good look at a comparison of how these pit stops all shook out once the guys all get back to the racetrack.
Travis Quabble had the lead for a couple of laps, but now he relinquishes it to come in for the pit stop, and that gives the lead momentarily to Brendan Gaughan. Here's Quaple making a stop, Ray.
Quaple was loose earlier in this race, and they did a little bit of tightening for him on that last pit stop. This time, Rick Renn said the truck was good enough. They didn't need to make any change, so there'll be no air pressure changes for them at all. They get the jack on the left side. Took them just a little bit of time to get the left side of that truck jacked up. The fuel was already in. Those guys done there, waiting on the left front, and Quaple will head back to the racetrack.
Quaple moves back out onto the racetrack as Brendan Gaughan has the lead here with 67 laps completed in the American Racing Wheels 200. Here on ESPN, the American Racing Wheels 200 from California Speedway, and 71 of the 100 laps have been completed. Now, everybody has made their pit stop. Presley went from first to fifth. Quaple lost a couple of positions. Musgrave moved up two. Leffler down two, and Gaughan lost a couple of positions.
Big winner. Look at Corey Gibbs all the way from seventh to second. Great pit work by those Doug Hewitt and those guys. Rick Crawford up three spots. David Starr lost three spots. Setzer gained one, and Bliss gained one.
And so Musgrave has the lead here with Corey Gibbs running in second position, then Crawford third, Quaple is fourth. The 18 truck of Robert Presley is being shown in fifth position, and then the 2 truck of Jason Leffler. Let's get an update on the pit situation from Ray Dunlap.
Well, Bob, I'm not really sure why David Starr lost positions, because they had a routine stop, just did 4 tires and fuel there, no real changes, and it didn't appear like it was a long stop at all. Now, the 62 of Brendan Gaughan stayed out the longest, so apparently he was getting pretty good fuel mileage. He took on 4 tires, but the reason he lost some positions was because they pulled a spring rubber out of the left rear, and that slowed him down just a little bit. Now, you'll notice that Coy Gibbs is up to the top of the pylon right now. That's because they had a very fast pit stop, 14-2. They did 2 right side tires and fuel only, so not a left side tire change for the 2. And the yellow is now out.
And the yellow comes after everybody has made pit stops. But it is our second caution of the afternoon, and it comes on lap number 74.
Bob, all these guys can go to the rest of the way, so are they going to pit? If they need to make another adjustment, I think they'll pit. But otherwise, these guys, a lot of these guys may stay out.
Robert Presley, I should say Ted Musgrave, slows them down as the pace truck comes out once again. That allows us to take another break. We'll be back with more in a moment from Fontana, California. Caution flag is out here at California, and we ask if there might be some that make pit stops during this caution, despite the fact that there have only been a few laps run since pit stops. The answer is yes, at least Mike Bliss and David Starr. Here's Ray.
Well, Bob, Starr had definitely nothing to lose where he was at on the racetrack. Little surprised that Bliss came in, but they said, let's do 4 tires here and take the track bar up 2 rounds. Right before that, Dave Fuge Sr., who's on the roof, said, let's not pit. We need to keep our track position. And Mike said, I think we can make this truck better, and we got to try to win this race. So that's what they're on pit road for. Starr gets his work done, pulls the spring rubber out of the right rear there, and these two guys will rejoin the pack. But boy, can you believe a gamble with just 25 laps to go to lose that track position?
Yeah, the guy who is battling for the championship here, the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, gives away a lot of track position to come in for another pit stop. Well, Bliss has been through many changes in pursuit of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series championship. Now, as the goal is closer than ever before, he reflects on what's brought him to the brink of that dream.
After I started racing, I knew this is what I wanted to do. I think ESPN has done everything for my career. Money's not part of what makes you happy. It's winning that makes me happy. After I finished 33rd at Daytona, I thought it was gonna be a long, long year. My goal is to win the championship, but I just don't wanna hex anything.
In his 6 years behind a wheel of a truck, Mike Bliss has had a lot of good and bad luck. But this year, as he closes in on a career milestone, we ask him about his highs and lows along the championship trail.
I've won a lot of different races, and probably in the Craftsman Truck Series at North Wilkesboro, that first win, it was a kind of an odd week. We fired the crew chief, and Jimmy Smith said that Barry Dodson was going to come down and just kind of help us out and watch us and put a lot of input in that day, and we ended up winning that race in the Ultra Wheels Ford, and it was a big win. I still remember that. I shouldn't have really probably left Roush Racing. I should have stayed where I was. I think of the rides I have gotten out of and people have gotten into and been successful. Kurt Busch is a very good race car driver. It would have been found by anyone else if I wouldn't have stepped out of that truck. I should have stayed there. I thought Winston Cup would be, you know, I was ready for it. I wasn't ready for it. Seeing what it takes to be in Winston Cup as a team, it is an eye-opener, and it's very, very difficult. As a driver, I think I sat out a year. I didn't want to sit out a year in 2001, but I think I've matured since then. I know how to, I don't push it over the limit of a race car. I seem to know where that limit is more, and I know what I want in a race car. And I've got a good crew chief and good people to give me exactly what I want. If I win this championship, my biggest goal is to go back and win races. And if it's with this IWX team, that's what I want to do. If it's with a Busch team or a Cutfield, it's got to be a successful team. I don't want to go backwards again. I've done it, and I don't ever want to do it again. I want to be where I win in races. And if I live my life in the Craftsman Truck Series the rest of my life, that's great. I enjoy it. I just want to win.
He was a 1993 USAC Silver Crown champion, and now Mike Bliss seeks his first championship in NASCAR. Has completed, as you said earlier, Phil, all but one lap since he had that bad luck at Daytona, and has come on now to lead points. However, at the moment, Rick Crawford has trimmed the margin to just 41 markers. Back in a moment. Just two races to go after this one, and the next one will be at Phoenix International Raceway, the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, next week in the desert. The championship hunt rolls on, and former Phoenix winner Mike Bliss will be trying to continue his march to his first NASCAR Craftsman Series truck title. Watch all the action live on ESPN2 Friday, November the 8th at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. Down to Ray Dunlap.
Well, Bob, hopefully we'll be back to green flag racing soon, but the reason that we're under yellow is because Jason Small blew up, right?
Yeah, we broke our crank today. We started vibrating about 40 laps into it, and it finally gave up on us.
This is one of the drivers, guys, that's trying to figure out what he's going to do next season. A few guys not totally sure what truck they'll be driving in 2003. We'll be back with more from California after this.
Welcome back to California Speedway. Alan Porter waves the green flag, and we are racing once again in the American Racing Wheels 200 with only 16 laps to go. And Ted Musgrave is at the front of the field as he leads them down. That's Coy Gibbs running in second spot. Rick Crawford in third. Quapple is fourth. And the 18 truck of Robert Presley is running in fifth position.
Look at that run Rick Crawford got through the center of the corner. He turned the truck left, jumped in the throttle, drove right up beside Coy Gibbs. He's got to get up to Ted Musgrave. He's got to do it quick. We're inside of 20 laps to go.
Now, Mike Bliss has made a couple of stops during this lengthy caution, which was for oil on the racetrack, and that has dropped him back to the last truck on the lead lap, or at least at one time, 14th. He has, since the green came out, passed one, and Bliss is running in 13th position. But, boy, the championship is just getting closer and closer.
Well, that wasn't smoke through turn four right there. That was still the residue of the speed dry left over, but it should be hopefully green from here on out here. There's Robert Presley, the back of that pack on the right, in the 18 truck.
And there are the points as of now, 42 separating Crawford and Bliss. By the way, we have had 8 leaders and 14 lead changes in this event, and that is the most lead changes since the very first race of the year at Daytona. Musgrave is going to get the bonus points for leading the most laps. He's led 35 at this point, and there is Mike Bliss continuing to try to move up through traffic. That's Bobby Donner on his low side.
He's rattling a couple lap trucks right there. I don't know if I want to be in the middle, being the point leader.
That's Lance Norrick in the 90 truck that he just passed.
So
saw a glimpse of David Starr, the blue and white Spears truck. There's David Starr's right there. He's on board. He's behind Mike Bliss right now, so David Starr desperately needs to get up there and gain some positions. He's another one of the guys that pitted on this last caution flag. Most of the guys stayed out, but Mike Bliss, David Starr, and John Wood, and Bill Lester, all lead lap trucks, are the only trucks that pitted that were on the lead lap when the caution came out.
Lester now the last truck on the lead lap in 14th, and John Wood, we haven't talked much about today, is also having a good race. He's in the lead lap running in 13th position. There is Starr, who is 12th at the moment.
There's another guy, Andy Houston, is in the 10th position. I don't think we've mentioned Andy at all, given that Billy Ballou Ford, a great run, 12th last race at Vegas in his first run on the 15 truck, got a top 10 going here.
90 truck of Lance Norrick up there on the top side is not on the lead lap. This is not a battle for position here with Starr. Norrick is running in 17th spot, one lap down.
It's certainly aggravating David Starr right now. You get inside of 20 laps to go, you don't want to have to mess with a lap truck. And right now he's having to race tooth and nail with Lance Norrick trying to get by him to get him catch the trucks on the lead lap.
There is Bliss once again. Now Matt Crafton is right on his tailgate, and Ray has an update on Bliss.
Well, Bob, you talked about him coming down pit road a couple of times. They had made a track bar change on the 16 to try to loosen him up, but with just 17 to go when we restarted there, Mike said that's not going to be good enough, so they came back down pit road and put the track bar exactly back the way it was. The one thing Mike says he wished they'd have done is not take a full load of fuel there. They put the truck back to a full load. He said that might have been a little bit of a mistake, trying to keep that truck the best he can get it here at the end of the race.
Ray, the reason why he didn't want to put it full of fuel, because if he puts it full of fuel, that shifts weight to the rear, and that makes a truck tend to be a little bit loose getting in the corner, and I think that's what Mike was worried about. That's why he came back in and lowered his track bar. So that was a position right there. That was 4 points when he passed Terry Cook. So he's marching back towards the front. There's Andy Houston we just talked a moment ago about. He's in the 10th position, or the 9th position right now, ahead of Mike Bliss. So every position right here that Mike Bliss can get is another 4 points.
Coming up on Andy Houston in the 15.
And the two-time pole winner at this racetrack knows how to get around this racetrack. He finished in the second position here a few years ago, back in 2000, I think. Remember now, Mike Bliss has pressure tires on a lot of these guys, too, because he changed tires on that last caution flag. One of only three or four guys to pit.
And Bliss picks up another position. Meanwhile, Musgrave has checked out. The interval between himself and second place Rick Crawford is more than 2.5 seconds. Bob Jenkins, Bill Parsons, and Ray Dunlap back at California Speedway in Fontana for the last 9 laps of the American Racing Wheels 200. Ted Musgrave is the leader of the race at the moment by almost 3 seconds now over the second place truck of Rick Crawford.
We're looking out the back of Ted Musgrave's truck right now. You see what he see, Bob?
Yeah.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. And that's the best thing he's seen all day, is nothing behind him.
Coy Gibbs running in third position. Leffler is fourth. And the fifth place belongs to Robert Presley. And here is a good battle among those drivers that we just talked about. And there also, on the right of your screen of the number 60 truck, is Travis Quaffle. So this is third, fourth, fifth, and sixth.
Boy, Gibbs has lost a couple spots here, or actually potentially losing a couple spots. Jason Leffler is able to gain the third position. See if he can go after Rick Crawford now, who's running in the second position. But look at three wide behind him.
Whoa! Into turn one. Three wide as they go in there. And Presley backed off for a moment.
Great move by Travis Quaffle on the outside. Drove up on the outside of these two guys. It looks like he might be able to pull off this pass for the fourth position.
Travis has had a good run here this afternoon.
See, Robert Presley pulled down behind Coy Gibbs, and as soon as he pulled down, it just gave him a little shot of air, and it pushed him by Travis Quaffle. But we'll see what Travis can do fighting back through the center of the corner.
Of the two caution periods we've had in this race, the average speed is down to 138 miles an hour. But when the green has been out, we have seen some great racing.
Another three wide race for a moment there. Brendan Gaughan pulled up on the outside. Robert Presley was able to squirt by Travis Quaffle on the inside, but here's Brendan racing Travis for the sixth position.
Now less than 8 laps to go here at California Speedway.
That's Presley, Gaughan, and Quaple as they battle 5th, 6th, and 7th position. All this about 4 seconds behind the leader of the race, Ted Musgrave.
You know Ted Musgrave, Gene Nee, Jimmy Smith, all those guys. They have over a 3-second lead. We saw what happened in the last 3 races. You know, they're not counting a thing until I see that truck come off turn 4 coming down for the checker flag. They're biting their nails.
We documented earlier in the race that so many times Musgrave has been denied victory when it appeared to be his, including the race in Las Vegas a few weeks ago. But he, at the moment, does have things in hand as he watches all of this action behind him. And now Leffler challenges Crawford for second.
We saw Leffler early in the race use that outside groove to really make some time. Looked like he was going to be able to pull up on the outside of Rick Crawford, but Rick kind of pulled up the racetrack. And it allowed Corey Gibbs, that slowed his momentum enough down to allow Corey Gibbs to pull up on the inside of him. And you've got Robert Presley on the inside of Corey Gibbs.
Presley and Brendan Gaughan also right in the thick of this battle here. Oh, they're 3 wide, and look at Gaughan way below the white line.
Down on the apron to try to make this pass. Going to continue to go through turn 1 side by side, 3 wide. Robert Presley, the loser on that one, middle of the racetrack.
Less than 6 laps to go. We'll take a break and be back for the finish. It's Musgrave, Crawford, Leffler, Gibbs, and Gaughan in California. Welcome back to the American Racing Wheels 200 for the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series here on ESPN. Just 5 circuits to go, this 2-mile track. Watching the 14 truck of Rick Crawford battle with Jason Leffler for the 2nd position on board with Leffler. And here comes Crawford to the inside. The lead held by Ted Musgrave. He's about 3 1/3 seconds ahead of this group of cars.
Jason was able to get by Rick Crawford here while we were away and take over the 2nd position. So now we have teammates, Team Ultra, running 1-2 with Ted Musgrave and Jason Leffler in 2nd.
This has just been an incredible performance by Ted Musgrave. Again, he changed engines before qualifying, started 31st, and has led almost half of this race at this point.
He said he was going to have to get aggressive, take some chances. Right now, he's going to lead, already clinched, leading the most laps.
Yep.
He's going to get 185 points today if he can hold on for 4 more laps. So he's done all he can do.
There's Quaple and the 20 truck, Coy Gibbs, 4th and 5th positions.
Travis pulled up on the inside of Rick Crawford. Rick Crawford does not want to give up these positions if he can help it. Each one of these positions up here in the top 5 are with 5 points. So 5 points could be big when we get down to the end of the season.
And just to keep you updated on the leader in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series points coming into this event, Mike Bliss, he's now up to 9th spot. So he isn't going to lose a great deal, but will lose a few points if things continue this way to the checkered flag. At the moment, Crawford has a 58-point deficit to Mike Bliss, but that's cut the interval quite considerably here, which is 2 races to go.
What a great run by Brendan Gaughan through the center of the corner to get by Travis Quaple. I thought he was going to be able to pull up on the outside of Rick Crawford. Not quite able to do it that corner, but a great run going for the Napa Dodge of Brendan Gaughan. Look at through the center of the corner. Look at him drive up on the outside of Rick Crawford. Not quite able to do it. Rick able to get squirt in front of him just enough to block his momentum.
2 laps to go now for Musgrave.
The problem is for Rick Crawford, if he lets Brendan Gaughan get by him, he's liable to bring Travis Quaple with him, and that would be 10 points. He desperately needs to stay in front of Brendan Gaughan and Travis Quaple, but right now Brendan's on the outside of him.
And Quaple to the inside. They go 3 wide, and let's see if Crawford is able to maintain his position. And they're close.
Wow. Brendan able to keep the momentum up a trap. Rick Crawford finally able to get by Rick Crawford, but Rick only lost the 1 position. It looked like he might have lost 2, but he only lost 1 that lap.
The white flag is waving. Brendan Gaughan has moved up to 3rd spot. That's Crawford 4th, Quaple in 5th position. This is the battle for 6th between Presley in the 18 and Coy Gibbs in the 20 truck. So Ted Musgrave just about 1 mile of racing to go, and he's going to successfully defend his victory here.
If he makes it back, Bob.
Yeah, let's not count it out or count it finished until the checkered flag has waved. But he's looking good. Has that Mopar truck right down on the bottom of the racetrack. Now swings high off of corner number four. And Ted Musgrave from Franklin, Wisconsin, is going to win it.
Great run for Ted Musgrave. Jason Leffert, teammate, finished second. You heard Jimmy Smith said he wants both his trucks to do a side-by-side parade lap.
It's his 10th career victory for Ted Musgrave. Ray?
And we got a Dr. Crew Chief Gene Need. Now, that guy came on the radio and told you as he's coming off four, he's got a flat. Did you about have a heart attack?
Nah, I figured he was kidding us. After the last about five races we've had, I wouldn't doubt it. So.
Unbelievable dominant truck. You got to be awful proud about the work these guys did, putting a new engine in and be able to be that strong.
Yeah, I mean, everybody on Ultra Motorsports team, I mean, both teams, the one and the two, you know, when we had to change the motor, there was red, white, and blue shirts and black and white shirts changing the motor. So, we got to thank our teammates as well as everybody on the one team. So it was a great day for us.
They went to the tail, ran to the front, dominant fashion. Your winner is Ted Musgrave.
He won at Darlington, he won at Dover, and he records his third victory of the 2002 campaign by taking the checkered flag first here at California Speedway in Fontana.
That makes the last two or three races a little bit easier to swallow now that they got back in victory lane here. First time he's been able to defend a win from the previous year. So two-time winner here for Ted Musgrave.
Hey, some impressive donuts here, my Ted. And Jason Leffler was able to get around Brendan Gaughan and take second position, and that's the sixth time this year that Leffler has finished second.
Had a great run going. Early leader, very, very strong early in the race, and actually gained on Ted towards the end of the race, but ran out of time. He had to pass a lot of trucks. But again, it's still a terrific run for Jason Leffler and the Team ASE Dodge.
Ted Musgrave started in 31st position, and not only was he able to win, he led more than half of the race. He led 51 laps. There were eight different leaders besides Musgrave. The leaders included Presley, Starr, Leffler, Gaughan, Quapel, Crawford, and Mike Bliss, who only led two laps, but did get, of course, the points for doing so. Well, Ted's headed for victory lane, and so is Ray Dunlap. We'll have the interview when we return.
For the 10th time in his career, Ted Musgrave is in victory lane. And folks, we were going to bring a stepladder over here to make sure he could get out of this truck okay. Hey, careful there, old guy, careful. Yeah, go ahead. Oh, okay, no problem. Hey, dominating fashion today. You said you were going to do everything you could to go after this championship. You got 185 points today.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's what all this Team Mopar is all about, is we've had some bad things happen to us, some flat tires, but this group of guys back here, and Jim Smith and everybody, and I got to thank everybody at Dodge, you know, stick behind us. We're still going for it.
Okay, now we go to Phoenix, then we go to Homestead, but here's my question. You're going to be running Winston Cup that weekend, too. Is that going to be any distraction?
No, I can't make any distractions. You know, that's just a little play toy for us, more or less, that Jim and them guys have, you know, kind of offered me for a little reward. This is the number one deal right here, to try and win races and win championships for Mopar and Dodge. But, you know, like I said, we're going to try hard to put on a good show for the Winston Cup deal, too.
Can you go to both those racetracks and win? You had one at Homestead a year ago.
Well, I hope so. I mean, this truck here has just been really good. This is the same truck we ran at Las Vegas. We're taking her to Homestead, that's for sure.
Okay, and what about changing an engine? Were you worried at all that there was going to be any problem?
I never worry about these guys. You know, actually, the motor really wasn't nothing going on. It was just a little bit of a water leak. So we just put this motor in. We knew this one was a good one, and they're all good. It's just like I said, we just went with an insurance. So coming from the back, no problem.
Ultra Motorsports does it again. Victory Lane, finish 1 and 2. Ted Musgrave comes back to Victory Lane for the third time this year.
Well, he won 7 races in 2001 and does record his third victory of the year here this afternoon. Leffler, Gaughan, Quapel, and Crawford complete the top 5. And the top 10 includes Gibbs, Presley, Setzer, Bliss, and Terry Cook. Favorite is in 10th. And Starr, who started on the pole, ended up 11th.
Andy Houston, a good run, finished 12th, started 12th, finished 12th. John Wooden in the Navy, Ford, finished 13th. Bill Lester, good top lead lap run in 14th. Great run for him. And Bobby Dotter, another top 15.
Let's go down to Ray, who's with Mike Bliss.
And he'll get a ninth place finish today, Mike. I know you're probably not satisfied with that. You made a lot of changes to the truck to try to make it better, though, today.
This IWX Chevrolet was just way too tight. We'd start off pretty free, and I thought we'd be good at the longer run, and then it just went real tight. We came in for four stickers there at the end with hopefully it'd go longer, but then we got real tight again. We tried freeing up. We just couldn't get it free enough to run.
I know you were loose in happy hour, and then you guys made some changes. Did you go too far?
Well, we went back to where we were in practice the first day and then freed up a little bit there. Something was wrong. Our balance, we just didn't have a good balance through the run.
I know you wanted to blow this championship away, but guess what? It got tighter.
Well, I mean, I didn't think it was going to get easier as it went. We stayed out one time just to get 5 points. You know, we thought that would be good, but Rick got 5 points too. So, I mean, it's going to be a battle clear to Homestead.
And these guys have two different trucks ready for the two final races of the season.
So the battle gets tighter and the championship battle continues. Now, here's the remainder of the finishers in the race today as Contreras, finishing in 18th position, was the last truck just one lap down.
Gary Hill, good top 20 run for him in 19th. You see some of the guys that had some trouble. Steve Portgay was out of the race. Jason Small, we saw him blow an engine. Here's the final finishers. Phil Bonnefield, 31st. Wayne Edwards. And how about Ryan Hemphill? What a great run he had going this weekend. Was not able to run the race because of some slight injuries from yesterday, but hopefully he'll be back next week in Phoenix.
That was a very bad crash during happy hour, but Hemphill will be okay. Ray?
Well, a year ago, Brennan Gaughan was in victory lane in the Winston West Series. You had a good run here today. I'll tell you what, it looked like you were giving it all you got. Good third place run today.
We were the second best Dodge out there, I think. We had something for Loeffler, but too many yellow laps killed us in the middle there. I didn't see any oil, but hey, I mean, we came here with the truck that the Dodge that crashed in happy hour at Vegas. And we came here and didn't put a scratch on it. We knew it's one of the best Dodges ever built, and American Racing's my sponsor and really wanted to win that trophy, helped design it, and it's a pretty cool trophy, but congratulations to Ted. Hey, aren't we the three teams that don't need free wheels?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, you know, it works either way.
All right, that's Brendan Gaughan. Let's move right over here to Travis Quapel. Travis, tell me about your day today. I know you guys worked awful hard on that race truck.
Yeah, we had a real loose truck the first part of the day, and I don't know, long runs, we had the truck to beat. I went by and passed Ted and the 18, all them guys under green, but I don't know, after that caution, the truck was just way too loose. It took me four or five laps to get going again. Once we got heat back in the tires, kept around store Chevrolet, drive to front, but just kind of ran out of time. I just wish we didn't have all them caution laps.
One victory so far this year, two more chances to do it. Tell me about your chances to win at Phoenix or Homestead.
Well, Phoenix, we're debuting a brand new Silverado, and Addington Racing did a good job putting it together. I know it's going to be a great truck there, short track racing. I really thought we were going to get one today, but we'll go get them next two.
Cat Reynolds will not be back next year, and I know you've had your eye on what's going on out there. Can you give us any news about where you'll be in 2003?
I wish I could. You know, right now I don't really know what's going to happen. I know Addington Racing is looking really hard for a sponsor, but right now it's up in the air. If anybody wants to come aboard, we need your help.
There's some space available. That's Travis Quapel. Has a good run today, finishes fourth here at California.
Well, here are the points with two races to go, and nobody changed position, but they sure did tighten up. Remember, there was an 85-point interval between first and second coming into this race. It now is 68, and there was 169 interval between first and fourth coming in, and now there's a 177. But up front, the top three are even closer than they were. Crawford just 68 behind Ray. He still has a shot at the championship.
Yeah, and a pretty good smile here for Rick Crawford. I know you thought you had a shot of winning today, but you did make some moves in the points race.
That's what we came here for, and try to win this race. Had a truck that could win Ernie Elliott Motors under the hood. Race talk is understanding the evolution of this chassis changing because we're second faster than we were when we come here last year. True definition of the word, that's racing. You hear that a lot with race car drivers having wrecks and things like that and saying they'll go on to the next race. You had 12 trucks here today in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series they could have won, and I thought we were one of them. We took a top five. We made some gains in the points for the Circle Bar race team, and proud to be part of it.
Did you keep track of how many times you went three wide out there? It was pretty crazy.
I was just having fun. That was great racing. I don't think we got a scratch, and I don't think anybody did. It was running up front, and I watched them for a while. I led for a while, so I had a great day.
Okay, what truck you taking to Phoenix? This one or another one?
No, I ain't taking this one. I'm going to save this one maybe for Homestead, bring it back out then, pack some more bullets into it, and I got a surprise for you at Phoenix. That truck will run.
All right, that's Rick Crawford, and I wouldn't be surprised to see him in victory lane at one of those places. Remember, his one and only career victory in this series came at Homestead in 98.
Crawford did lead two laps in this event and had a very good run. We will take a break and be back with more as Ted Musgrave has won the American Racing Wheels 200. Coverage of the American Racing Wheels 200 from Fontana, California, being brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And Craftsman, the official tool of NASCAR and NHRA, celebrating 75 years of making anything possible. Ted Musgrave wins here at California. Jason Leffler finishes second, Ray.
Bobby did it at St. Louis, Pikes Peak, Milwaukee, Michigan, IRP. Are you tired of hearing about that list of where your second places are?
Well, not lately. We've fallen off the last couple of races, so to get back running the top five is great. What a great day for Ultra Motorsports, all our sponsors, Team ASC, CarQuest, Dodge, Arrington Engines, and of course those Ultra Wheels. But what a great day. I'm happy.
Maybe you should change that truck number to number one.
Yeah, I don't know. Ted had an awesome truck, and they ran into some problems yesterday in qualifying, so... But we had a good truck. Second set of tires, the balance was off a little bit. But other than that, it was a pretty smooth day.
If you had any more laps, did you have anything for Ted?
I don't know. He's such a veteran, it's hard to tell. I was catching him, but he might have been just backing off and then running a comfortable pace. But if I would have caught him, I would have tried to pass him.
Tell me about the action out there. We saw a lot of three-wide action today.
It sure was. This track's awesome. You know, the surface has matured, and it's widened out where we can run three or four wide. And I love coming to a place like this. I can run up high, down in one and two. No one else wanted to run up there, so I had my track to myself, so it was great.
Two more chances this year.
Yeah, two more chances, and looking forward to Phoenix, one of my favorite tracks. I've had a lot of success there, and hopefully we'll get that deuce in victory lane.
Okay, that's Jason Leffler in the two, and now David Starr will step in here. David, you win with a team effort, and today, unfortunately, you lost with a team effort. Little problem in the pits.
Yeah, that's okay. Hey, the guys did the best they could do, and we had a little mishap, but that's okay. We charged and did it the best we could do, and we just so happened didn't have too good of a finish. But, the truck was a little loose in the center, and we worked on that all day long, so we never could get it just perfect. But, we'll take what it is and go on to Phoenix next week.
Did you learn anything today that would make this truck better next time you come here?
Well, I hope so. We learned a lot, during the race today. You hate to say you learned something. You're supposed to be up front racing for the lead, but that wasn't what happened. So we learned some stuff and some stuff what not to do next time we come here. But, hey, it was another halfway decent run, and just a shame we didn't get up there and get the race for the lead.
Okay, that is David Starr, and, guys, as you can see, he finished 11th today.
And the celebration is continuing as Ted Musgrave and team are having their photos taken in victory lane. Well, tell me about the race, first of all, and then tell me about this championship that obviously is going to go right down to the checkered flag at Homestead, Miami.
Well, Bob, as far as the race goes, all the guys in the garage here, all the proposing crew chiefs, said Ted Musgrave was in another zip code. But through the middle portion of the race, it looked like a lot of guys were going to be able to run with him and even pass him. But at the end of the race, he came on, he drove away from his teammate Jason Leffler and everyone else and put this truck in victory lane. He started in 31st or 32nd, wherever it was, way in the back. And he was actually back up to in a lead by about the 25th or 30th lap. So a dominating performance in this championship. It gets tighter. It's got tighter. He gained 40-some points. Rick Crawford gained a few points. We got two trucks inside 110, or three trucks inside 110 points. It's going down to the wire.
It should be good. Ray?
Well, guys, Andy Houston started 12th and finished 12th, but boy, I don't think anybody worked any harder today than you did.
No, really, we did have to work hard. I just can't say enough about Gary Showalter, the crew chief, and all the guys that work on this thing, all three of them. We're really doing a lot with a little. We got three guys working in the shop, and to come on 12th, we come on 12th last week at Vegas, and we come on 12th here today, but that says a lot for this team. Small race team. Billy Blue's, poured his heart into this thing, and if he could get some, sponsorship deal for next year, he would like to run full time. And I'm happy for these guys. Give them a little bit of success here towards the end. And 12th in the past to me has been, kind of a problem, but now I'm satisfied with it, and we'll go to Phoenix and try to get him there.
Okay, and Andy Houston, one of the guys, of course, we're hearing a lot about, might be back driving truck full-time next year. And Bill, tell me about your day.
Well, it's pretty much been the gamut of emotions this weekend, Ray. We were really elated when we qualified third, and we were very optimistic going into the race. It was a big surprise because we were practicing 12th and 13th prior to that. And so in the race, we were a little bit disappointed because we couldn't get really the freeness in the middle of the corner out, and we were just so terrible tight on exit that it just killed us on coming off the corners. And so finishing, I guess, 14th or whatever it is, I'd be lying to you if I said we were pleased with that. But, I mean, I got to commend the guys, Bobby Hamilton Racing and Dodge, for sticking with me and bearing through the season of a rookie such as myself who doesn't have a whole lot of experience here. It's been pleasurable.
Okay, I don't think it'll be long before Bill Lester gets into that top 10, guys.
Well, two more races to go this year in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series with Phoenix next. You can see that on ESPN2, the 8th at 3 o'clock Eastern Time, noon Pacific, and then the finale at Homestead Miami Speedway. The story today was Ted Musgrave, who started back in 31st position, led 51 laps of this race, and went on to beat Jason Leffler and Brendan Gaughan to the checkered flag. Thanks for joining us. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com.